The U.S. government now investigating a massive internet outage to determine whether it's the result of a cyber attack. Congressman Adam Schiff is the ranking member of the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence. He's joining us from Washington. Congressman, what can you tell us about this? Was this, in fact, the result of some sort of cyber attack on the United States?
Wolf, we still don't know who was responsible. I spoke with the administration within the hour about it. Obviously, Department of Homeland Security is looking deeply into this. It's of grave concern, but at this point, it's too early to say what was the cause of this, who was responsible, what the motivations may be.
We did get a statement from the White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest. He said, I've seen the reports. I know the Department of Homeland Security, that is the U.S. government agency that's responsible for monitoring our security in cyberspace and coordinating with the public and private sector to protect U.S. interests in cyberspace, is monitoring the situation. They'll take a close look at it. At this point, I don't have any information to share about who might be responsible for this malicious activity. The fact that he's calling it malicious activity suggests cyber attack probably was the result of this massive outage of the internet.
I had exactly the same impression from that language, Wolf. I think certainly you would imply from that this was the result of a cyber attack, not the result of some accidental technological malfunction. But I think there's still in these early hours a lot we don't know about just how this took place. But if it was a cyber attack, I'm confident with the forensic capabilities that we have, we'll get to the bottom of where it came from, and then figuring out, of course, the why is also of vital importance.
We know that you believe, and others in the U.S. intelligence community believe, that Russia has been responsible for the cyber attacks on the Democratic National Committee, other Democratic Party organizations, if you will. Do you also believe, I just want to be precise, that Russia is directly responsible for the cyber attacks, the WikiLeaks documents that have been released, the emails of John Podesta, the Hillary Clinton campaign chair?
Well, I certainly think that and I can only comment at this point on the publicly available reports, but I think that the Dell report that came out recently by that private security firm was very credible. And that report concluded that the Russians were behind the hack and release of the Podesta emails as well. I also think what the Director of National Intelligence and Secretary of Homeland Security said prior to these Podesta hacks about the DNC, that the method and the motivations were consistent with Russian practices is true of the Podesta emails as well. And of course, it's perfectly aligned with the efforts they have given through their hacking and release of helping Donald Trump. So I think that certainly is a very credible public report that this private agency put out and very consistent with what the Russians have been doing all along, unfortunately.
Donald Trump questions whether Russia is responsible for the hacked emails. I want you to listen to this exchange that Trump had with Hillary Clinton during Wednesday night's final presidential debate.
I think it's
she
time.
Has no idea whether it's Russia, China, or anybody else.
I am not quoting
she has
myself.
No idea.
I am quoting
Hillary, you
17,
have no idea.
17 intelligence. Do you doubt 17
our
military
country has
and
no
civilian
idea.
Agencies? Well,
yeah,
he'd
I doubt
rather
it.
Believe
I doubt it.
Vladimir Putin than the military and civilian intelligence professionals who are sworn to protect us.
How conclusive is the intelligence that Russia is directly responsible for the hacking, that Putin himself ordered it?
Well, as Director Clapper said as recently as yesterday, they don't say that they have confidence in an intelligence judgment lightly. Here, I think the evidence is really quite overwhelming of Russian involvement in the hack and release of these emails. Donald Trump knows better, and I think when he denies this and says that nobody knows, Secretary Clinton doesn't know, essentially the Director of National Intelligence doesn't know, what Donald Trump is really saying is that my campaign is more important than the national interest. And if I have to deny the obvious facts, if I have to carry Russia's water, I'm willing to do it. Anything in the service of my campaign, and that is not someone we can afford to have as Commander-in-Chief.
Just moments ago at his rally, Donald Trump was speaking, and he really lashed out at President Obama and Hillary Clinton, among others. I want you to listen to this.
We have a bunch of babies running our country, folks. We have a bunch of losers. They're losers. They're babies. We have a president. All he wants to do is campaign. His wife, all she wants to do is campaign. And I see how much his wife likes Hillary. But wasn't she the one that originally started The statement, if you can't take care of your home, right? You can't take care of the White House or the country. Where's that? I don't hear that.
He was referring to some statements that were made 8 years ago when Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama were both running for the Democratic presidential nomination. I don't know if he was exactly quoting Michelle Obama accurately. We'll check that out. But give me your reaction when you hear that kind of assertion from Donald Trump.
Well, honestly, my reaction is keep it coming. Here he is attacking a popular president and attacking an even more popular first lady. It's a terrible campaign strategy, and it's one that isn't going to attract anyone new to his campaign or to support him or win over anybody that's not already devotedly in his camp. This is just the kind of thing he's been doing all along. In fact, and I don't know whether it actually happened, but there were reports he was going to bring the alienated half-brother of the president to the debate. What's the point of that? It's such a distraction from what his message supposedly is, and I just think it's a terrible campaign strategy, and it's why his campaign is really just going down the drain.
All right, Adam Schiff, the congressman from California, thanks for joining us.